I love candy. I have a crazy sweet tooth. But if I have too much of it, I will just be like, ugh.
To Fast Company's 100 Most Creative People list. Your luxury candy brand, Sugarfina, is booming. When did this entrepreneurial spirit and gift for creativity start to show up?
I think it's something that as a little kid, I was always that kid who was being super creative without really realizing it. Like, I'd just go off and be making friendship bracelets or doing all these kinds of arts and crafts. And I definitely skewed more towards the creative side, but then I also really loved the business side. So when I started babysitting, you know, I started a babysitting business. And I was kind of like always turning these things into little businesses. But for whatever reason, I didn't connect the dots that that could actually be a career path. And it wasn't until I met my now husband, Josh, that I realized, oh my gosh, I can totally do this and this can be an actual career.
Your company kind of started in this whimsical way. Take us back to the very beginning. How did you come up with the idea to launch a candy boutique for grown-ups?
So Josh took me to see Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory on our third date. You know, we both loved that movie as little kids, but we said to each other, where did the magic go around candy? It was kind of this idea of a candy store for grown-ups that got us thinking and brainstorming. And for about 2 years, we would travel, we would go discover interesting candies in Europe and Asia, meet with the candy makers, kind of learn the story of where the candies come from. And we were basically doing it for ourselves and our friends. We kind of amassed this big collection of delicious candies. And then one day we decided to launch the company.
Well, starting and scaling a business is, of course, no joke. It takes so much hard work. So what were some of your early challenges, and how'd you overcome them?
There were a lot of things neither of us had ever done before. We've never been in food, we've never been in retail, we've never been in e-commerce. We were really making it up every single day. We did everything. So, you know, Josh would be, you know, teaching himself how to write legal documents, and I'd be teaching myself how to put together a website. But that's also can be really stressful. You know, you don't ever have an easy day. You're always in this kind of like constant uphill climb.
When did you two know you hit on something really big, something that had the potential for this massive success?
Well, in the beginning, we launched online, and every single order that came in, we knew exactly who it was. It was like, oh, that's my sister. Oh, that's your mom. I remember there was this one day where we had our first order that we had no idea where it came from. Real people are actually buying product from us. And then only a couple days after that, we had someone say, oh, hey, I just got this gift from your company, and I love it. And that was kind of the moment where I realized, oh, gifting, like that's what we're about.
You have an incredibly innovative approach when it comes to Sugarfina's branding, store design, and overall customer experience. So what is your best advice for any company that's striving to be a disruptor rather than be disrupted?
Well, first you gotta ask yourself the question every day, what is everyone else doing and how can you do that very differently? So with candy, most people go into a candy store and they expect the pick and mix, like you're scooping with a shovel into a plastic bag and kids are sneezing and putting their hands in it and it's just gross. And so we wanted to do something that was the complete opposite of that. You really have to break all the rules and do things that people haven't done before. And also think about who your end customer is and what is gonna make them wanna get out of bed in the morning and come to your store or go to your website. As an example, last year on April Fool's, we fake launched green juice gummy bears and people just went crazy for it and they're like calling us and coming to the store, how do I buy this? And we're like, we're so sorry, but it's not real. But at that moment, the light bulb went off. We reached out to Press Juicery, which is one of the biggest juice brands. They loved the idea and it sold out within about 2 days.
Innovation, of course, requires asking questions and challenging sacred cows. Why do you think so many organizations struggle with this?
I think a lot of people are really just coming from a place of either complacency or being a little bit fearful about it. It takes a lot of guts to say, well, let's do this differently. You really are taking a big risk. And I think that you have to have a company culture where if you try something and it fails miserably, that's okay and that's part of the process. And that's really the culture we have. We try a lot of things and a lot of them work really well and a lot of them fail miserably. And you just pick yourself up and you learn and you move on. people always ask, well, what do you wish you could go back and change about your life? I really wouldn't change anything, because even things that were really challenging, they make you who you are today, and I wouldn't want to change that. You guys are with sound like how some people are with wine. It's like, I have notes of like citrus and leather. You're like, it's a truck backing up.